What's up, my peeps? After like 7 years, I'm back with a prediction video for Hell in a Cell of all pay-per-views. Was gonna do it for SummerSlam, should have done it for SummerSlam, was gonna do it for SummerSlam, but didn't end up doing it, and the thumbnail for this video was actually supposed to be the thumbnail for that video. But anyways, let's get down to the predictions, and we're gonna start it off with the SmackDown Tag Team Championship match. By the way, I have no clue what the kickoff match is. It might be this one, might be something else, I don't know. Doesn't say anything on the WWE website. So, it's gonna be the New Day versus Rusev and Aiden English. First things first, Rusev Day winning this match took me by surprise. I thought the Bar would be the ones moving on, because they already have a match with the New Day at that Super Showdown show, or I think that's what it's called, in Australia, right? So I was thinking, you know, just like AJ Styles and Samoa Joe, who already have an announced match for that show, that was just going to be another rematch. But I guess not. So Rusev Day moves on. They're in the Tag Team Championship match here. I think the New Day is still going to win the match. Regardless if the Bar or Rusev Day were going to win, at the end of the day, I still thought the New Day would retain. I know that recently Aiden English, you know, has been successfully helping out Rusev, and it seems like their relationship has improved, and, you know, Rusev's happy with Aiden and this and that. Re-listening to myself there, sounds like I was talking about them like they're in a romantic relationship, which obviously isn't the case, but you guys get what I'm saying here. But if you ask me, this is just to get the fans behind Aiden English when Rusev decides to turn on him. I don't think it's going to be the other way around. I think Rusev is going to be the one to turn on Aiden after he loses the match or gets pinned or something like that. Might happen in Hell in a Cell, might happen later on, but I do think the reason why they've had Aiden English, you know, push Rusev aside and sacrifice himself for Rusev and save him from a chair shot, this and that, is to have people really feel bad for Aiden once Rusev actually turns on him. So I'll say the New Day win this match and retain their tag team titles. They just won them anyways. I don't see them losing it that soon. Moving on, another tag team match. This time the Raw tag team titles. Dolph Ziggler, Drew McIntyre defending the titles against Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose. Alright, so I think it's pretty clear by now that Dolph Ziggler and Drew, actually it was pretty clear immediately once they won the tag team titles, that they won them so that eventually they could go ahead and drop them to Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose. A lot of people think that Seth and Dean are just going to win the tag team titles this Sunday. Personally, I think not. I think they're going to hold on to them for just a little bit longer. I don't think they're going to drop them right away, because then you give the Shield all the power. The Shield right away has all the championships. I think there has to be a battle for those tag team titles or for all the gold. So I think for now, Drew and Dolph Ziggler will hold on to those tag team titles to keep the chase going. So as far as this Sunday goes, I say Drew and Dolph Ziggler win the match via some sort of fashion. Hey, it might even be a DQ. Bottom line, they keep the titles. And hey, Super Showdown, they've got the Shield versus Braun, Drew, and Dolph Ziggler. That might just be a winner-take-all match where the winning team takes all the championship gold. And maybe that's where Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins win the tag team titles. On to tag team match number 3. Don't worry though, this is the last tag team match. Daniel Bryan and Brie versus The Miz and Maryse. I'll keep it pretty simple for this. Look, we know the feud isn't ending at Hell in a Cell. We know that they've got a third match at Super Showdown, Daniel Bryan versus The Miz, with a future championship opportunity on the line. So if it doesn't end at Hell in a Cell and Miz won the first match, logically it would make sense for Daniel Bryan to win the second match, so you keep it going and then you have the tiebreaker at Super Showdown. Plus, I'm pretty sure the reason why they brought back Brie and made this a mixed tag team match is to prove that when Daniel Bryan and The Miz are facing off in an equal playing field, no one has an advantage. Daniel Bryan beats The Miz and The Miz needs Maryse's help. So if The Miz and Maryse still win in this situation, then it kind of failed to prove that point. Now on to the first of two Hell in a Cell matches, Jeff Hardy versus Randy Orton. Now I didn't expect this to be one of the Hell in a Cell matches at the pay-per-view. I just thought it would be a regular old rematch between the two, so this took me by surprise. I thought if SmackDown was going to have a Hell in a Cell match, it would have been for the WWE Championship, AJ versus Joe, which I'll get to in just a few. But as far as Jeff versus Randy, a lot of people are expecting Jeff Hardy to pull off something crazy, to go outside of the cell, go up top of the cell and jump, maybe a swanton off the cell or something like that. Here's a fact for you. 2 years ago, Jeff Hardy stated that one of his dream matches would be a match against The Undertaker inside Hell in a Cell. Well, he's not getting Taker, but he's getting the Hell in a Cell part, and I'm pretty sure one of the reasons why he wanted to have that match against Taker inside the cell was because he wanted to do something crazy, like something off the top of the cell. Thing is though, with this not being the main event Hell in a Cell match, with this being the first one on the show, I don't think we're gonna see something too crazy with Jeff. Because here's the thing, after this match, because I don't think this is gonna be the main event, I'm pretty sure it's gonna be the Universal Championship match, Roman Reigns is gonna have to wrestle Braun Strowman inside Hell in a Cell. So I don't even know if they're going to be able to break the cell, because Roman and Braun still have to use it. Now, they could maybe get out the cell without actually breaking it, like through the door or something like that. Then, if that's the case, maybe Jeff Hardy pulls something crazy. But then again, would they want Jeff Hardy and Randy Orton to outshine Roman versus Braun? I don't know. Anyways, I'm just here talking about this crazy spot, but you might be wondering, who do I think is actually going to win? I'll say Randy. I'm pretty sure Randy wins this one. Oftentimes, when it comes to somebody like Jeff Hardy, like a Shane McMahon, or, you know, somebody who pulls off, like, high-risk maneuvers in matches like this, it tends to cost them the match. So if Jeff Hardy, which I do think he will try and pull off something, might not be, you know, off the cell or whatever. If he does try and do something, I think it'll fail and Randy will capitalize and maybe hit an RKO for the win. Or even better, bring back the punt kick. I'd love to see Hill Randy bring that back. Next up, Charlotte versus Becky Lynch. The SmackDown Women's title on the line. First things first, man, I do think that Charlotte Flair will eventually become a 16-time Women's Champion just to match Ric Flair. And plus, we've seen her win the title so many times now, pretty sure that's gonna happen eventually. So in order to do that, she's also gotta lose the title a couple times, but I don't think she's losing it this Sunday. I think this feud is gonna keep on going, and Becky will likely get another championship match, but she's probably not winning it this Sunday. And plus, on SmackDown, Becky Lynch did get the upper hand on Charlotte. Actually, she's gotten the upper hand on Charlotte most weeks on SmackDown, so going into the pay-per-view, Becky definitely has the momentum. And oftentimes, when somebody has the momentum going into pay-per-view, especially in the case of Becky, where she's taken out Charlotte a couple times now, they end up losing at the pay-per-view. So I say Charlotte wins, and even if she doesn't win, she retains somehow. Afterwards, it's the Raw Women's title match, Ronda Rousey versus Alexa Bliss. Don't care for Ronda, but I do think she's gonna win this match. Now on to the SmackDown main event, AJ Styles versus Samoa Joe for the WWE Championship. This, like I said earlier, I thought this would be a Hell in a Cell match. At least I think I said it earlier. But no, it's not a Hell in a Cell match, it's just a normal match. I'm surprised, especially with how the last match ended. AJ Styles got disqualified, so you would think they would go ahead and make the next match a no disqualification match, and since it happens to land, or since it happens to happen at Hell in a Cell, it would make sense to have it inside the cell, especially with how personal this feud has become. The two possible reasons that I can think of why this isn't inside the cell is because they know this is not going to be the end of the feud, because they're having a third match and everybody knows this now, and the other reason would be that they didn't want too many cell matches with him one card, and they definitely wanted Jeff to have one of the cell matches so he can pull off a crazy spot inside or outside the cell. But anyways, it's not a cell match. Who do I think is gonna win here? This is a tough one. Honestly, out of all the matches on the card, this is probably the toughest one to predict for me. Initially, I was like, maybe Samoa Joe wins, but now I'm leaning towards AJ Styles more. And at this point, I think they're gonna have AJ Styles hold on to that title until he surpasses CM Punk's championship reign. Now, I know a bunch of you might go, well, hey, they already did that with Brock Lesnar, but Brock did it with the Universal Championship. If we wanna be specific here, Punk did it with the WWE title. And AJ Styles now has held that title over 300 days, so he's kind of close to CM Punk. So if they did want to do it, they've got a phenomenal opportunity here to do it with somebody who's universally liked. So for that reason, I'm going AJ Styles on this one. And here's the thing, even with AJ winning this match, both him and Joe are going to be 1-1. Because Samoa Joe technically won the first one. AJ Styles got himself disqualified, so the Super Showdown match, the third one, is gonna be the tiebreaker. And finally, the main event inside Hell in a Cell, it's Roman Reigns versus Braun Strowman with the Universal title on the line. It's Braun Strowman cashing in that Money in the Bank briefcase. I think this is the first time where the heel actually announced beforehand when he's cashing it in. Like, hey, it's gonna be at this date, at this time. Well, he didn't say the time, but you know, the date. It's inside Hell in a Cell. Oh, and by the way, that I mentioned Mick Foley's the referee. So he's cashing in, it's inside the cell, and he's doing it because, according to Braun Strowman, that way, you know, Roman Reigns' friends, the Shield, can't get involved because, you know, Edge never got involved inside Hell in a Cell. Kane didn't get involved in the first one. Chris Jericho didn't recently get involved inside Hell in a Cell. Bray Wyatt didn't teleport inside the Hell in a Cell structure. You know, all of that stuff never happened. Look, people get involved inside Hell in a Cell matches, steel cage matches, especially when the superstar emphasizes that he's picking the match so that nobody else gets involved. Happens a lot, actually. But anyways, whether the Shield gets involved or whether Drew and Dolph Ziggler gets involved, whoever gets involved or whoever doesn't get involved, it doesn't matter, because at the end of the night, the result will be the same. Braun Strowman will join the exclusive list of superstars who have cashed in that Money in the Bank briefcase and failed to capture the championship. So pretty much, bottom line, I'm saying Roman Reigns is going to be Braun Strowman this Sunday inside Hell in a Cell, and you're going to hear JoJo say still the WWE Universal Champion, Roman Reigns.